Okie dokie. And here we are. This is the first time I've done like 7 days in a row with this. Hey, Dyer, what's going on? Good evening, Mage and Dyer, and I think I saw Arenis in the chat. So, hi, how you guys doing? So I'm gonna try to get this finished up. I only have a couple more things to color, and then we can go on to the next page. So, fun times. What's going on? How you guys doing today? I feel like their hands should be a little bit thinner, actually, now that I'm looking at my line art. Aw, I'm sorry to hear that you are sick. My kitty cat is sick too, as I think I've mentioned 4 or 5 times in the last couple days. She's being pretty good right now, but seems like it's the time of year for everybody to get a little sick, I guess. I'm sorry you're not feeling good though. I let the day get away from me a little bit. My sister and I finished up all of our Christmas shopping, so we don't have to worry about that at all. We just have to get our butts home for the holidays, and we're good to go. So, you know, that's a thing. Feels good to be on time for once this year too, because usually we're pretty behind. I was watching Luke Cage before we started. I started a little late because I was trying to finish the episode I was on. The show's really good so far. I'm enjoying it quite a lot. All the Marvel Netflix series so far have been pretty good, though. I don't know if you guys are into superhero movies and TV shows, but I've really enjoyed the Netflix series so far. Just kind of had a little bit of a lazy day, which was nice. It was nice to just relax for a little while and not have to do anything crazy, you know? I took, like, extra good care of my apartment this last week, so I didn't really have any crazy, like, cleaning up to do this weekend, you know, just vacuumed quick because there's cat hair literally everywhere, but so it was good to have just a lazy day, because I know tomorrow's going to be insanity. But then again, what else is new, right? You guys getting all ready for the holidays? That actually, nothing reminded me of anything, I just remembered it. Hang on. As ready as one could be. Yeah, that's true. The holidays are a crazy time of year. You are not wrong. I'm not ready to leave my cat for a whole 5 days. I think that's maybe the thing I'm looking forward to least about going home, is that I can't bring my cat with me. I'm gonna have to leave the bubble by herself. Luckily, my neighbors are super sweet and they're gonna take care of her, they said, so that's a load off my mind, but I still am gonna miss her. I suppose in hindsight I should have just not gotten a cat, but, you know. What's the fun in that, right? Are you worried the gift won't get here in time? Yeah, fingers crossed, dude. But oh, by the way, Mage, I was gonna tell you, I opened up the Discord app on my PC to update the stream schedule tab, and of course you can imagine what the first thing I saw was when I opened the app. I totally forgot about it, and I also didn't realize it would open on the same conversation the next time I opened it, but it did, so I got a little chuckle. It made me laugh because I forgot about it. Like, oh. Oh. Yep. I'm not going to say the word. We're not even going to get on that subject. I just wanted to share that a particular piece of artwork that I saw yesterday was still on my screen when I opened up an app again. Is it? What is up with this mic? Okay, hang on. Let me, I don't know what to do about that. Like, okay, so I don't know. Maybe you guys can help me. I don't know literally anything about microphones. Do you think turning the gain down would help? Like, the other way? Like, not increasing the gain, but decreasing the gain? Here, let me put it in the middle and see if that helps. I really don't know how to stop it from doing that. Ugh, microphones. This will be a constant struggle for the next few weeks trying to figure out. That made it considerably worse. Okay. Hi, Dead Mouse. Sorry you've come in with me fiddling with this microphone. Sorry. I talk nice and quiet for a moment. I'm sorry. Okay, we're gonna do some live editing. I'm gonna talk in an ASMR voice for a moment so that I try not to peek you guys. This is a very nice mic also. How to stop a microphone. OBS. I'm going to ask the Google machine. The other thing that's hard is that I can't hear myself, so... Like, I don't know if it's being fixed or not. Put the gain back on. Okay, is that any better? Well, the mic is already, like, a foot away from me. I mean, it's a good, like... I mean, it's pretty far away from me. I have... Oh, so you mean I shouldn't yell into the microphone, is what you're saying. Here, let me, okay, we'll try this for a little bit and see if that helps. It sounds fine right now? Okay. I put a gain filter on OBS, and I also turned the gain on the mic itself down, so we'll see if that helps at all. Let me know if it gets bad again, though, because, I can adjust some more. I'll try not to scream and or laugh loudly. And hopefully that fixes it. I'm gonna have to fiddle with the microphone on my own time, though, and make some recordings of myself talking to see if I can figure out what's up with that, because that shouldn't continue to be a problem. It's weird because I don't know why it suddenly just started, too. Because that's a relatively recent development. That wasn't happening a few weeks ago, I don't think. Unless you guys noticed it and didn't say anything, but maybe it wasn't as bad as it was. Or as it is, rather. Maybe at the time it wasn't as bad as it is now. I don't know. I don't know enough about audio stuff to, like, know how to fix that. I'm not even sure, like, what I'm looking for on OBS to... Weird. Yeah, I don't know what would have caused that. But we'll try it on this setting, and hopefully that makes it better and not shitty. It's funny, I never had any trouble with my other microphone peaking. I just had a lot of trouble with it disconnecting on me, which is a considerably worse issue. But keep an ear out for me. Let me know if it gets really bad again, and we'll adjust. It's interesting that it just kind of started out of nowhere, though, but I don't know anything about, like, specifics of audio, so I don't know what would have caused it, to be fair. Oh, actually, I was gonna make a new layer up here, but I already have a folder set up for the guys on the bottom, so... Get that out of here. Dead mouse is a bag of cats disguised as a human, apparently. Well, unlike the YouTube greats like Markiplier and PewDiePie, I will attempt to not incoherently scream into my microphone, and hopefully we won't have any more issues. And the Blue Yeti will play nice, at least until I can look at it a little bit closer on my own time. I don't want to do too much fiddling around with it live, but... You know, I can certainly mess around with it tomorrow afternoon after I get home. We'll figure out what the problem is. I wonder that too. Cause it like it, it cause it. I wonder if it has something to do with, like, so I'm doing all this stuff live, and my microphone is going at the same time as the video, and it's all playing at once. I kind of wonder if maybe YouTubers, I don't know if they're like, I don't know if they record it in something like, that bird has the same hairstyle. And I also deleted the sketch layer that was there, so that's fun. That's a thing that happened. Hang on, let me remove that. I want to undo, delete that later. Oh, yeah, I never changed this one's hair. Okay. Flip. Flip. Whatever, we'll just, keep doing what we're doing, I guess. Is that a thing? Is that something you can only do, like, in post, though? Or is that something I could do, like, right now? It could be that too, because I certainly do not scream. There was, I think the only time I ever screamed was that one time that that creature in, what was it, Spooky's? Spooky's House of Jump Scares startled me. I think that was the only time I've, like, full out screamed. But usually I don't talk very loudly. My downfall is my laughing. I am a very loud individual when I laugh, so it makes it hard for me to talk at a single volume because my laugh is so much louder than everything else. I'm just a loud human being, I think. It certainly could be that, though, that their voices are just naturally louder and they're prepared for it ahead of time. I always wondered if it was like a, you know, editing and post sort of thing. Not necessarily like that's specifically it, but something to do with it. Does it play every time? That's funny. There's a couple of songs that this shuffle just really likes for some reason. I even stopped doing the shuffle through YouTube so that it wouldn't, like, repeat songs, so that we could just hear all new stuff, but it still comes back. So, I posted that, that screenshot of, I posted that screenshot to you guys of the EX pass I got in Pokemon Go. I posted that on a local Facebook raid group, because everybody had been complaining about how difficult it is to get an EX pass, and so there was this big discussion about whether or not Mewtwo should just be like a normal raid, and a bunch of people disagreed. Most people actually, for some reason, were in favor of Mewtwo staying as a you know, like a special raid. And I agree with that sentiment, but I was surprised at how many people agreed with me on that. And what was kind of interesting to me was that everybody agreed with my point too, is that it's too random, and like I should have gotten a pass for the same day I raided at least. But somebody in the raid group offered to do the raid for me. And it was so nice of him, and, like, I've met him before, so, like, I totally trust him to do that and, like, not fuck up my shit, but, like, he just, you know, he commented on the, like, somebody, well, it was somebody else, like, a third party, tagged him on my post and was like, oh, this guy did it for me once. He took my phone to the raid location and did it for me because I couldn't go. So, and a bunch of other people were like, oh yeah, he does that kind of thing all the time. And then this guy was like, yeah, I'll do it. And I've met him before. Like, I've run raids with him during the, like, weekends. So I think I'm gonna maybe let him do the raid for me. So I might still get a Mewtwo. Which, I guess it's not as much fun as getting it yourself, but considering that I physically cannot leave work to do it. I mean, Plan C was to, you know, just work extra late during the week and try to get out early so that I could go, but hey, if somebody's willing to meet me at my job, take my phone to a Starbucks 30 minutes away, and then bring my phone back to me, I am 100% okay with that. I feel like maybe in the interest of not getting my phone stolen, though, I should get, like, some kind of collateral. Like, hi, please don't steal my shit, thanks. Nugget, are you having fun? Nugget was telling me about, you were telling me about that motorcycle you're trying for in Zelda, and it cracks me up that there's a motorcycle in Zelda. Just so many, I have so many questions. In that folder. Okay, there we go. That's what I wanted. Then the nice thing about masks is that you can just do that. Beautiful. So did anybody do anything interesting this weekend? Anything fun going on? I mostly got trapped under my cat all weekend because she's being extra snuggly, so I didn't do very much at all. Was kind of okay. It was nice to just stay in for a little bit. Oh no, I didn't think you were. I was remembering it and it was funny. It was funny to me. Okay. Hollow Knight. I don't know that I have heard of Hollow Knight. Can I make this guy's eyes like a color? Even if it's just like a pale yellow, the white's a little bit strange. I don't know why I chose that as the color. Speaking of bugs, I found a spider on my wall this morning, and when I went to try to move it, it was, like, not moving, so I was like, oh, well, it's dead, so maybe it'll fall off the wall at some point, and then I came back later, and it was still sitting there. And I kind of thought, you know, if it's dead, it'll fall down on its own, and I won't have to deal with it, but it didn't, so then I tried to take it down, and it was still alive. I don't know why it was chilling there, but speaking of bugs, I know it's not the kind of bug you were talking about, but... Hollow Knight is a popular indie Metroidvania. It's often compared to Ori, but plays differently. Okay. So it's like a more combat-focused, though. It's kind of that, like, platformer style. Interesting. Hey, SS guy, what's going on? Yes, it's art. We do art and talk about game. I'm surprised I haven't heard of Hollow Knight, to be honest, but I have not, so... So it's that same sort of level of just ultra-difficult craziness that you would get from a game like Dark Souls, but it's obviously not the same thing. I considered that when I was dragging this. I've been sort of keeping an eye on that, speaking of difficult games, not with the intent to play it, but I've been seeing that, I don't know what the name of it is, the name is escaping me, but that game where you, that just came out, it's made by the guy who made Quap, that has the, it's the guy in the cauldron with the sledgehammer, and you have to, like, climb the mountain or whatever, is that what it's called, something like that, scale the mountain, something like that? Something about a mountain. Maybe it's not. I've been seeing that all over the place recently. I don't know what's with people in rage games. I don't have the patience for that. Hey, stop sign! Stop sign and SS guy, how you guys doing? You guys just got in here. That game looks hard as shit, though. No thank you. I'm good over here with my Ori and the Blind Forest. That's enough difficulty. Getting over it, yes, that's what it's called. That game where you play the guy with the sledgehammer in a cauldron. Yes. That one. That game looks just insanely difficult. Not on my list of things I wish to play, even a little bit. I'm good on that situation. Thanks, though. Did you have any ideas in mind on what you'd like to draw us as guy, or just, not sure? You know, do you have, like, a list of things you want to work on, or and just can't decide on one, or you're not sure, or just period? Any, characters you could work on? I don't know if you're a character creator, but... I think you've posted some stuff in the Discord, I just can't remember. You got a present, that's awesome. Why is that not the same color? Now it's the same color. That was weird. Alright. Oh, maybe you haven't been in the Discord then. Yes, we have a Discord. If you are interested, we have a Discord. You are more than welcome to join, and we have a channel just for sharing art. So if you want to share anything you're working on, feel free to post it. We love seeing each other's art. I think that's been one of my favorite things about the Discord so far, is getting to see what everybody's working on, because everybody's got something a little different that they're doing, and it's fun. Yeah, if you want to join on into the Axie Stack, come on over. I promise that you will get the warmest of greetings. there's one thing I can guarantee you, it is that. The link to it is, the link to it's under the video. Oh, Mage got it for you, never mind. Yeah, I always have the Discord links always under the, video, but Mage is always on top of that, so I never have to worry about it. Actually, I just remembered I put the Discord app on here, so we can look at it right now. Yes, welcome to the Axie Stack. Yeah, this tab, the art share, you can go ahead and post in there if you'd like. Yeah, in this tab here, you can just drag and drop whatever you want to share. Let me scroll up and let's see. Oh, a record player, that's pretty cool. Actually, surprisingly, I am not that cold. Oh, you're okay. I remember you now. Sorry, there's so many names and I forget everybody. I remember your Mantis. Oh, she's cute. She looks so good. I love that you did the color variants and showed how her eyes look too. You've improved on her design even from the first time you sent her to me. Oh, I like her a lot. Yeah, she's a good for a main character. I really like, I think beetles are really fun to work with because they have such interesting shapes and colors. Butterflies are fun too because they also have lots of fun shapes and things. Those would be my suggestions. You know, pick like a beetle that's cool or something. Stop sign, you call me whatever you want. And I'm actually not as cold tonight. Since my cat's not feeling good, I want to make sure she doesn't get too cold, because last night she was really hawking after anything that was warm, so I think she was a little bit, chilly, and so I turned up the heat today. Usually I don't turn up the heat as much as I did, just because I don't want to spend the money on the electric bill, but if she's not comfortable, then, because I need her to get better before I go on vacation. She can't be sick while I'm gone. So, I know I still have I have a few more weeks before I go home for Christmas, but I just want to make sure she gets better, and so, I made sure the heat was up a little bit today. So I'm actually not super cold today. I don't know, some days even if I'm bundled up super tight, like if I get like a blanket and a sweatshirt and long pants and socks, I'm still cold. I just can't shake the chill. If that happens to me sometimes, it's weird. My body doesn't like me sometimes. Oh, do it, Mage. Hang on. Now that I have this app, we can do it. Yes, post it. Yes, this deck grows. Yeah, dude, post it. Show us. I want to see. That's not what I wanted. Nope, that's not what I wanted. I want to color in these splotches so that everything's all even. Today was interesting because I woke up and it dropped 30 degrees overnight. Oh my god. Mage. That's insane. I had a very jarring experience the other night. Woke up and it was like, the worst it's been is I woke up and it was like 60 something degrees in my house and I was just not happy about it at all, but you know, you just turn the heat up and life goes on. Someday I will live somewhere where it doesn't get as cold as it does here and then I will be fine. That's the goal. The goal is eventually to move somewhere where I will just not freeze to death every winter. Oh, that's so cool. Yes, Heprotech. That's a cool drawing. He's so cool. Oh, look at you guys. You guys are awesome. Yes. No, we better not. Can't click on can't click on mage this stream. And no, you're never gonna live that down, because I'm just gonna giggle about it every time I see it. I don't even care. Like, it's not like I'm judging you. It just, it makes me laugh, because literally every time I open the app, you know, if I click on you for any reason, it's gonna be there. I guess that means you and I have to talk more to push it up the page a little bit. I could also go west. I could go to the state that is currently on fire, and then I will never have to be cold ever again because the entire state is literally a fire. See, that's the trick. It can't snow in California because it is... It is not able to snow in California because it is on fire. Can't have snow if your state's burning. Snowing ash is better than snowing snow. At least ash is not cold. I know it's not better. I'm only joking. I'm only making a joke out of the fact that I'm freezing literally all the time. And I'm also sad that your state's on fire, and I'm sorry for that. I am literally 100% making a joke. Luckily my sister hasn't been hit by it yet. I don't know what's, I hope Apple's okay. Don't come to Florida. I wasn't planning on going to Florida. No offense, Florida seems like kind of a shitty place to be. I haven't heard good things about Florida. I'm pretty sure we're attempting to saw Florida off and let it float into the ocean. Like, I'm pretty sure that's something that's occurring. I think one day you guys will just be an island in the middle of the ocean. Oh, do not merge visible. Stop that. Merge layers. There we go. Overlay. I like that your dragon's just like, oh, fuck it. Oh, I got hit. That sucks. Oh, that's unfortunate. I'm only gonna make this reference because I've been watching Luke Cage a lot, but he sounds like he'd be a lot like Luke Cage. Just like, oh, that's unfortunate. One of my favorite lines so far in that show has been, after Luke gets shot up in a boxing, like, dojo area thing, and he just sighs and goes, I'm really getting tired of buying new clothes. Like, I feel like that's why your dragon guy doesn't wear clothes, is because he would just get so tired of buying new clothes. So he's just like, well, I guess I'm just gonna wear a loincloth, and that way if somebody tries to stab me with a sword, I can't cut my clothes because I'm not wearing any. I do like your description, though. He's too shiny to care. That does make me giggle. The phrasing on that is good. I also forgot I'm not supposed to laugh quite as loud, I'm sorry. But yes, I'm glad you're taking that. He doesn't want to buy more clothes, so now he just doesn't wear them. I'm gonna try not to laugh so loud, I'm sorry, but I am full of joy and giggles. Yeah, you could do a slug or a snail. Oh, roly polies are great. You should do a roly poly. Are they called pillbug? I don't know what they're actually called. I call them roly polies. Can you though? Oh my god, nudibranchs are the best. They're so great and cute. Did I ever show you guys the? I'm sure I have. I have in here. I got the. I have a whole folder full of them. And by whole folder, I mean that I drew this lettuce sea slug one time. And also, I made this little pattern of pixel nudibranchs. And I converted them into cross stitch fabrics, but like cross stitch floss. So I've been working on on all of these in actual like physical cross stitch form. They're coming out pretty cool so far, but I haven't had a lot of time to work on them. But yeah, they're sea slugs. They're beautiful sea slugs. They're really tiny though, because you know they're small. They were only supposed to be a couple inches across. I have them in physical form somewhere in my apartment. Things you learned about Axie today. She likes to cross stitch and she's insane. Those. No longer need them. That's hilarious, though, that you made a celebrity snail character based on Taylor Swift. I don't know why you did that, but I love it. It's great. I don't know what connection you made between a snail and Taylor Swift, but I'm okay with that. SS, what kind of- are you building like a world with all your bug creatures, or are you just building bug creatures because you can? Either way, they're cool. I'm curious. A stop sign, that's awesome. What creatures did you create? Once I start building more, like sheets and stuff, I'll start posting more outlines, by the way. I know the outline I put in the Discord chat is just like for a species and not for like chunks of the world, so creating the characters for me is the fun part. Oh, hi, Fristinator. Did I pronounce that right? Fristinator. I think I put an extra I in there. What's going on, man? Welcome. We're drawing bird friends and talking about bug friends and slugs and things. Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, I don't know if you were going for like a story. That's neat. Deciding what rules you want to go with, I think, is the hard part. Originally, my world had a lot of like high fantasy elements. There was a lot of magic, and it was very like typical kind of Middle Earth kind of magic in it, and then I kind of scaled it back a little bit. It's a lot less magic based and a lot more character based. It's a little Guild Wars-esque in that sense, in that like magic's kind of part of the world, but it's not like the main focus. I think my world probably has a little less magic than something like Guild Wars. Like, not quite as low fantasy as Game of Thrones, but not quite as high fantasy as Lord of the Rings or like World of Warcraft, you know? Something like in between. Okay, yes, this guy. So there was no particular reason why Snail and Taylor Swift went together. It was just that was what it was. And yeah, Mage, as far as magic, I hadn't really thought too hard into it. I was kind of thinking that it would kind of, I did a little bit of world building for an indie group that was doing a pet website. I did a little bit of world building for them, Unfortunately, I had to drop them because I had too much other stuff going on, and I was so focused on their stuff that I wasn't doing any of my own stuff. And then I moved, so they were super great though. And they had kind of, I had done the magic for their world was a little bit like the concept of like chi, and it functioned a little bit like I'm trying to think of a good way to describe it. It functioned a little bit like almost like radiation for them, where it was something that was always present and it was kind of like spreading. And so if there was ever somewhere where there was like a vacuum of magic, the magic would want to fill it in, kind of deal. And I kind of want to adapt that idea into Lorhondal a little bit, that like magic is sort of a like a constant presence, and it will, you know, attempt to fill, like, kind of like, you know, just, it's like air. It, you know, it functions like air. So I imagine there would be, like, some people who are magically inclined that can, like, manipulate that, but not, it's not like a common thing, maybe. I haven't really put a ton of thought into it or written anything down. Originally, it was very high fantasy. There were, you know, dragons living in the sky, and people were magical, and, you know, there were different classes of element, just like in something like World of Warcraft, you know, fire and arcane and water, and I definitely scaled it back quite a bit, because I didn't really want to... I don't know, it felt like it was just the same as everything else that everybody else has been doing. Let me scroll back up and see what you guys said, because I missed a little bit of it. You are Mage Winters, fan of the magic arts. Monkeying around in magic is crucial. Crucial everything I do as a person. Yep, there you go. Yeah, Mage, go for it. Yeah, chat about it. Yes, a little bit like Avatar The Last Airbender, yeah. Not... Yeah, a little bit like that, definitely. I may have been subconsciously inspired by that. Actually, SS guy, if you are referring to the fact that axolotls eat insects, you would not be entirely correct on that. I don't know if axolotls eat bugs. I know they definitely eat fish, but I think if you put an axolotl anywhere near an insect, they would probably try to eat it. Also, stop sign, let me scroll back up, and because I missed part of yours, I think. Lizard species may look like a chameleon. That's interesting. You don't see too many chameleon species, actually. That'd be kind of cool. On the same continent as your wolf people? That's cool. Avatar is one of my favorite TV shows of all time. I consider that to be one of the best modern cartoons. I know some people won't agree with me, and for some reason there are people out there that don't like it. I don't get it, but if you don't like it, you don't like it. But I think it's one of the best shows out there. And I, you know, take a little inspiration from it. Not a ton, because it's not really it's not like the kind of stuff I want to write about, but, or create about, I guess. I don't know how much writing I'm doing, but... Yeah, axolotls don't really eat bugs, as far as I know. And I was gonna make, that was gonna be my point, was that axolotls don't really eat bugs, but then again, axolotls will eat literally anything, so maybe that argument is invalid. But yeah, Mage, you can talk about the magic in your world, that's awesome. Good weird, bad weird... I think they look pretty good. I'm pretty happy with them. Small bugs. Yes, maybe small bugs. They would try to eat the big bugs, but it wouldn't go so well for them, I don't think. Oh, yeah. Jedoa only have three fingers. Three fingers and a thumb. That's not the color I wanted. It's better, but not quite. Jedoa are the only species in Lorhondal with
4 fingers instead of 5.
Just an axolotl trying to eat something whole.
Literally an axolotl with, like, anything in its mouth. Just eating everything constantly.
I'm telling you, they're like infants. You can't leave too much stuff around or they're gonna try to put it in their mouth. I'm not wrong. I have one. He's an idiot, and he's adorable, and I love him. Yeah, the thumb's a finger. So, yes, they have 4 fingers and not 5. You are correct. Yeah, if any of you guys do any kind of world building or anything, feel free to share your concepts. Talk about what you got. I love hearing what you guys are working on. I think a couple of you guys do like D&D campaigns, so that's certainly a thing. This making progress. Right, so we got the images. Let's chuck these bad boys in here. Take this away from here, and these, away from that, and away from that. This one is 20, this one is 40, I believe. Actually, you know what? I gotta take it off these guys too, because they already have their texture, I believe. Or did they not? Oh, they don't have it. That can stay on there then. See you later, stop sign. Have a good day at school tomorrow. So, how does the concept of magic work in the world you're building, since D&D is a little different. I'm gonna make this 10 and 30. Yeah, that's better. It's a little too bright the other way. I think that already has the texture, and that already has the texture, yeah. So, okay, page 1 is done. Look at that. We finished a thing. Closed the other species sheet. Alright, what should we do next? I haven't decided if I wanted to keep this biology stuff. I suppose it's interesting enough. I'm gonna have to redo this, which is gonna be unfortunate. I suppose we could keep those. Doesn't bother me a ton. Let's do life cycle, since that's another big chunky project. And I don't have to... We'll just name all that stuff. By text. That's definitely saved as part 2, so I can adjust this as I please. Ah, good, I'm glad it's soothing to you. Hopefully my microphone hasn't been peaking and that's not a not a hindrance to your designing. You can thank Direcrow for the playlist, though. Direcrow offered to make me a playlist of relaxing music to listen to while I'm working, so, you know, that was pretty sweet. I typed the big old thing a bit above my idea. Oh, did you? How did I miss it? My idea for magic in D&D isn't that impressive. More or less, it comes from a god in which, in and of itself, is derived from the existence of elder beings. Did I miss your thing? Aw, thanks, Frisnator, for the follow. Welcome to the Axi Stack. I was telling Frisnator that you made the playlist. Frisnator, since you said you're an artist, you working on some world-building stuff too? What kind of stuff do you do? And on that note, if you're interested, we have a Discord channel, so if you want to join that, you can share your stuff in the art share tag. We got lots of cool artists in here. So good, nice fun variety of people if you'd like to be a part of that chaos. Let's see what we got. We gotta take this one big long box and make it into, I guess I could do these three across here, and then these three across the bottom. It'll just be another two-part thing. Thingamajig. Do you think I should keep it the same brown color? The background, do you think I should leave this section with this just solid brown, or do you think I should go back to this, like, tan and brown? I don't know that it makes that big of a difference, but... Is my paragraph description of magic invisible? Yeah, I don't see it. I saw... Let's see, what did I see? You were wondering about the concept of magic in Lorhandel because you are Mage Winters, an avid fan of magic, and then you asked if you could dish about your futile attempts to explain how it works in my world. And I said yes, and then SS Guy said some stuff, and Stop Sign said some stuff, and then you said, this concept is actually tied to everything in the story I'm writing about for my world. So somehow, that disappeared. Ah, Frisnator, that's awesome. Some portfolio stuff? Yeah, go for it. Yeah, link some stuff. Share your portfolio work with us. we enjoy checking out everybody's things, so you are more than welcome to share. Yeah, that's unfortunate if your thing disappeared. I think I'm gonna go back to the tan boxes, actually. This one's... the thing was, is because this was sandwiched into this dark area, it kind of worked, but... Actually, I could just take the stripes out, too. Maybe I should put, actually, since we have the whole header area to play with, maybe I should, That's actually a good idea. Since we have the whole header area to play with, maybe I should, put the biology together with the lifestyle stuff. Or life cycle, that was the one I was trying to say. Life cycle. And that way, actually, everything could be a little bit bigger. Mage, if you want to DM it to me on Discord, actually, I could just open it and we could look at it. Oh, shoot. Yes. Actually, good idea. Good plan. Ah, cool. You got a lot of, video game-looking characters. This is a really nice portfolio. Shows a good, nice wide range of different types of characters, and looks like there's a little bit of a variety in style too, which a lot of people like to see. They like to see that you can do multiple styles of things. Yeah, this looks great, dude. Hang on, let me open that nonsense up over here. I feel like I should have an art station because everyone uses it, but I don't, because I'm a nerd. slash this. Nope. This. There we go. It's unfortunate because I can't open the chat links on my this computer. Yeah, check these out, guys. These are cool. I like the different armor concepts are kind of like a little bit lower resolution because you're supposed to focus on this. Yeah, these look great. What kind of job are you looking to get with your portfolio? Your portfolio is definitely nice quality. I dig it. How many sheets total for this one? I'm thinking, that's a good question. I'm thinking, one. I knew this one would be the physical appearance would be the smallest because I had to include the header. That'll be like the first page. Second page is maybe going to be biology and life cycle together. Third, the other pages are where it gets a little tough because I don't know how much of this stuff I'm going to be able to fit on here, you know? I'm thinking maybe each of these tabs will become its own sheet, so all of the things about religion and entertainment, all the things about the city and the demographics and that kind of stuff, and then all the fashion and science stuff. I could rearrange the boxes, but I'm thinking maybe each of these columns will be its own page. Maybe one of them will be a little bit shorter and will include this little header. I might put the language stuff all on its own also. So maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 or 5, maybe 6 if stuff doesn't fit. And I date Captain Ranger. If I ask nicely, he stole my heart. Oh, you posted another one, sorry. We got, what else we got? I've never heard of cubebrush.com or .co. Ah, very cool. We did a project like this in college where we had to do, like, silhouettes, and then we picked a silhouette and developed the character further. That was, very cool. Well, you're definitely working in the right direction with that portfolio. Wish you luck on that. You're definitely going the right direction. All right, let's back up a little bit for a second. Let's do the fun orange line I did yesterday. I guess yellow this time. So if we do, like, so if I do the biology block exactly the way it is, so we just do, you know, skeleton. This is how I draw things, by the way. The cube. That leaves us the whole bottom half of the sheet to do this stuff in. So I could I'd leave the little tab there if I wanted. We could do the eggs, how mom carries the babies, and then the babies. They might even get a bigger block now that I have some space for it. And then we could do teenager, adult, and elderly here. And then that would give me a pretty full thing just for biology and life-based things. And then the next couple sheets can all be the society stuff. I'm planning to have a lot of these sheets just in general. You know, because I'm gonna do one of these sheets for each race, and then I might do some, like, more detailed ones, like, because down here, see, I've got fruit, so, like, I talk a little, like, very briefly about what some of the food there looks like, but I'd like to go back and do a more detailed sheet and talk about, like, this fruit is this, and it tastes like this, and you use it for this, you know? So, I'd like to do some more, you know, close-up things. Oh, and actually, I had some of these boxes, too. So we could do, like, lifestyle quick stats. That could go there. And then the leading causes of death could just stay where it is. That can go there. So this, I think this will work. You like my scribbles, by the way? They're nice, right? and actually, this stuff can stay here, too.
That's fine. I'm okay with that. Let's grab this box just exactly the way it is. Not quite right. Adjust for the new sheet size. Let me check, okay, so we're gonna do a plan. Okay, I'm gonna click this.
Alright. I noted that the stream is for mature audience, so, in the event of accidental porn, brace yourselves for dick.
Yep.
Or dick. Good. Ah, Discord, you kill me. Unfortunate. Well, that happened. Hang on. Let me chuck the BRB up there for a second. Let's open it, because I do want to read about your thing. I just need to copy it away from the dick. I apologize for showing your porn on live internet. It's a very nice piece of artwork, so... Yeah, he basically flashed the stream. He just, like... whipped his trench coat open and we ran for our lives. This is why I put mature stream up. Every now and then you might get accidental dick. Alright, so what we call magic in the land of Mundus Grande is actually the magically inclined channeling magical energy mana into various forms. Spellcasters absorb mana from the environment naturally and utilize it in their professions. However, the essence of magic is something we call ether. It is invisible to the naked eye, and no spellcaster can sense it. However, fluctuations in ether are what cause power droughts and surges in power of the mages. Without ether, there is no magic, because mana is derived from ether. Mechanics behind ether get more complicated after this point. I can totally tell you more if you want. Yes. That's, yeah. No, I dig it. So it's kind of like... It's a little bit like the kind of like chi concept I was talking about for mine, but it seems to be more like fantasy, like high fantasy, where like people can actually like manipulate it and do things with it. Is that, gotcha. Okay. Neat. And then let's one thing at a time, Katie. One thing at a time. Finish what you were doing the first time, and then we'll come back to it. Do not fret it right where you left it. At the moment, it's just something fun to do. Just, I wanted to kind of challenge myself in character design to just do this. At some point, maybe, you know, like, I guess I have some thoughts for, like, at some point I would like to do a thing, but, you know, like, really anything. I have some ideas for, like, stories involving the characters, but I haven't really put too much thought into it, like, specifically what I would want to do with them, if that makes sense. Like, they're just my little pet project for the moment. I did a children's book, sort of, with them, as my senior project, so that's certainly an option. But I don't have a particular plan. There is no particular... Not like I'm writing a webcomic or anything like that. It was something kind of fun to do to challenge myself a little bit to character create. I think it'd be really cool if it became something like a visual novel or a, you know, game or really anything like that, I think would be really cool. But I don't have any specific plans for it. Bleh. The nugget is back and he's bleh. Why are you bleh?
I need to put this dark color behind the,
behind this category. I have a bunch of different characters in mind. You know, lots of different, creatures and dating sim. Yes. Date your very own Jedoa. Of course, dating sim would get complicated very quickly when you get to Veos, because to date a Veos, you basically have to fight them and not get killed. that's how Veos date. You beat each other up until one of you doesn't die. Oh, Nugget. The struggle. Yeah, there you go. That's the plan. Jedoa dating sim. Perfect. You are not wrong. There is a dating sim that involves you dating a pigeon, so not that crazy. Certainly not the strangest thing that exists on the internet at the moment. That's for sure. And we talked about this the other night. The internet is a strange and beautiful place. And I'm gonna be pissed as heck when they take that away from us, because goddamn, I love the internet. Oh geez, Discord, no. Discord, what are you doing? Making this difficult for me. Actually drag that box all the way to the bottom. Unfortunate. Hey, new plan. Just do what I was gonna do in the first place, which is to just fill that in. Great. Good. War flashbacks, right? That's what I wanted. I wanted a nice little frame around that box. One thing I learned from my design class a while back is to pick two unique items, one man-made and one natural, and then use their function and looks as a point of reference guide as you design. Yeah, that's a good, definitely a good exercise. I really liked all of my, you know, character design type classes. Those were always super fun. I really liked those classes. Partially because I got to kind of do whatever I wanted, but also, you know, for a large part of it was really cool to see what people came up with. You know, people in my class had a lot of really different designs, and that was really cool too, to kind of see what people came up with. Which was a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun in that class.
Because the teacher would ask us for something very simple, and you would get a lot of different responses to it, and it was a very cool class to see what people came up with. Yeah, absolutely, for us, definitely.
Piece that layer style.
Boom. Okay. Let's do these, because these are easy. Thinking what I'm gonna do is I might actually open these in, open the artsy document. I like these eggs, and I think that they're fine, but I want to edit the baby a little bit because his legs are too long. So I would like for his legs to not be quite. That makes sense. Actually, the other thing that's going to be interesting with this is I gotta fit all the text on here, too. This. And got... There we go. Okay. Let's scooch on over. But yeah, see, this was the problem I had the first time doing this sheet, was I had to do all the images separate because I couldn't do them in this document because I had so much other stuff. It made it really hard to, it made it really hard to get what I wanted out of it. Let's see how much of this information I can fit in this space. Probably not even close to all of it. Actually, that's a lot better than I thought it was gonna be. Still pretty big. I'll do a little bit of, I'll do a little bit of editing as far as, text, because I don't think we need quite as much text there, but I just want to move the information over for now. 25. I asked for 25, thank you. Okay, so we'll have to redraw her, so let's do that. Got like 7 minutes left, so... Put everything in folders so I don't forget. Gonna be interesting converting these guys over to the new proportion, though.
one of these guys down here. But they've got a little bit bigger torsos now. Which I think was what I wanted to begin with. I think I wanted them to have, like, a little bit longer torso, and I couldn't quite get it. We'll have to make her a little smaller, but I'm just gonna keep drawing over top of this box, because I can. Egg goes there. Go there. I'm gonna stick off the top a little bit, that's fine by me. Actually, I need room for her text also, so she'll need to be a little taller and a little smaller. Got her eyes facing, like, down a little more last time. That's actually another really good question that I never put a lot of thought into. I'm not very musically inclined, so I never really thought about it, to be honest. I know it's something that I need to get around to thinking about, but, yeah, music was never something I was really good at. But deciding on that's a little tricky for me, I guess. I don't know. My instinct is to go for, like, your classic desert-sounding themes, but maybe that's too cliche. I imagine not too much stuff with, like, flutes, because it would be difficult for them to do things with their lips. I imagine maybe a lot of string instruments, because then they could play them with their hands. Probably a lot of vocal also, like a lot of chanting and singing maybe. Perhaps that fits the desert theme, you know, minus... This red is really hard to look at. I need to change that to a different color. Not yellow, not lime green. Blue is even worse. Okay, well, never mind. I imagine something like this, but maybe replacing the, you know, wind instruments with something else. I don't know. That's definitely a good question that I did not think about. Yeah, since they don't have lips, I imagine it would not be as many, not as many, you know, wind instruments, unless they, you know, invented an instrument that was, like, you know, something they could, like, squeeze, I guess, maybe. Mage didn't believe a bird couldn't play a flute. You know, this shirt doesn't actually really make any sense on this character. It is is occurring to me now that this does not actually make that much sense. Yeah, finding music that represents that character, definitely. I've gotten some of my best ideas from listening to music, and even if it wasn't something I ended up, like, an idea wasn't something I ended up using, just thinking about the music helped me out quite a bit. But, yeah, with these guys, I didn't really think of any particular kind of music. More or less, I think her necks needs to be longer, too. I gave them a little bit bulkier necks now, too. In fact, their necks pretty much go all the way up to their heads, so... I sort of was feeling like maybe, boy, this is a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. Converting them over to the new proportion is a lot more difficult than I anticipated. Yeah, I definitely think they would have a very distinct style of music, but I didn't think about it much. One I don't think would care that much about music, just kind of not really thinking about it that hard, would probably be Veos. I don't know that they would necessarily be super into music, but, proportions are all wrong on this. I don't necessarily think they would care too much. I'm sure their music would be a lot more like war chants and stuff, you know? I'm gonna do that thing I do. We're gonna grab this. Oh jeez. I can't get a proportion right. I do this. And you just draw over top what you have already. Just to try to match the proportion. Just to put her here so that I could draw on top of it. Music's definitely something I want to include. Sorry, I'm kind of focusing on... Make sure my proportions on this make sense. So then, Egu goes here, although Egu might need to be a little smaller now. That to make sense. These were inspired by those little strange baby slings you see moms carrying babies in now. I saw, you know, working at Babies R Us, I saw like a shit ton of these, and I just was like, well, I think that's how Jedoa should carry their eggs. I imagine that they just carry their babies in these little slings.
arm probably ends up back there a little bit, so that's fine. Yeah, I think that proportion's a little bit better. On its own layer? It is on its own layer. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna adjust this outfit, I think, even though you're not gonna see it that much, but it is a little bit tight-fitting for a Jedoa, so I think it'll be something, like, even if it has the collar, I think it's gonna be... You might not even notice it. Actually, that's probably fine, then the bottom can be open. I should maybe bring the egg up a little bit too. The other picture, she's much more relaxed, and this one I had to pull the arm in, so she's not quite as relaxed. Quick tip on how to find the elbow if you don't know how to find the elbow. And voila, there's the elbow. It goes over here somewhere. Elbow is somewhere along this line. I have to use that trick constantly because I always lose my elbows. I tell you what. Since it is... It's 11 something. I think I could probably reuse these guys, or at least draw over them, just to update their style a little bit, but I think I'm okay with this pose for them. Same thing with him. I think I'm okay with his pose, but I need to adjust his anatomy a little bit because his legs are too long, maybe. Or maybe his torso's not... I don't know. Something I think is not quite right about him. And then... Just some minor adjusting, I think, with proportions on those, but... Alright, that's where I'm stopping. We're stopping at this, mostly empty sheet. But I gotta get ready for work tomorrow. I don't know how crazy a day tomorrow was going to be, but I would rather not tempt fate. So, thanks so much for joining me, guys. Thanks for sharing all your art and world-building and everything with me. I like that you guys can come in and just hang out and share. So, yeah. Glad you guys like coming out and hanging out with me. I appreciate the company. So with that, I'm going to head off to bed. If anybody is in the chat that is not following yet, feel free to follow if you feel like you might want to come back and hang out with me another day. I don't know if there's anybody in the chat who's just lurking and hasn't followed yet. But and also the Discord's in the description, so if you want to, have a good time with a whole bunch of crazy people. We're here all the time, 24/7, for you. All right. Have a good night, guys. And have a good day tomorrow. If you got school, have a good day at school. If you got work, have a good day at work. And yeah. Oh, SS guy. SS guy has followed the stack. Excelente. Well, there you go. All right. Have a good one, guys. See you later. Bye.